Tak til Anne Lerke. Tak til Michael Bjørnsson. Thank you very, very much.
He's 62-1. Brian Nielsen, great record filled with B and C level opposition. Journeyman, club fighters, name fighters well past their prime, like Larry Holmes, Tim Witherspoon, Orlin Norris. Also rumors of mixed fights. While he has one of the best records in heavyweight history, he went 49-0 before his first loss. Here's the reaction of the crowd as they see him for the first time. And they will whistle along. Legitimate top 10 heavyweight in peak condition. In essence, his record padded for an eventual jackpot, and here it is, reportedly about $800,000. No introduction. Hearing who's from the crowd with Tyson, we've been conditioned to expect the unexpected, which can really put you on edge because we just don't exactly know how it will manifest itself if something happens. His infrequency of fights and questionable level of competition make his bid to regain the heavyweight title seem like he's taking the easy road to the top. Standpoint, what do you expect from Tyson here? Will the extra weight be a factor?
No, especially early on, I don't think it's a factor. Maybe late if the fight gets there. But early, I expect Mike to come in bobbing and weaving his head, working behind the jab, go right to the body, come up with left hook and uppercuts. I expect him to try and be a one-round knockout artist.
Well, in some ways, he's good for boxing. In other ways, he's not. He still gives people a rush. He's charismatic, unpredictable. Let's size him up as we check out the tail of the tape. Tyson, who turned 35 in June, a year younger than Nielsen, at 6'3", a 4-inch height advantage for Nielsen. Tyson also gives away 4 inches in reach. Both claimed the scale at the weigh-in Thursday was about 7 pounds off. Nevertheless, Tyson, a career-heavy 239. Nielsen, just under 260. Key rules, no standing eight, no 3-knockdown rule. A fighter cannot be saved by the bell in any round. And if a fighter is unable to continue due to an accidental foul, he loses by TKO, which is a very questionable rule, generally because it may encourage a fighter to foul knowing he's behind. So here in Copenhagen, Denmark, we're getting ready for the main event. Mike Tyson and Brian Nielsen set for the official introductions from our ring announcers, Moyens Newman and the classy Jimmy Lennon Jr.
samarbejde med Showtime Network byder nu velkommen til det største sportslige arrangement i Danmark nogensinde. Rigtig hjertelig velkommen til Parken i København.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to you, and we welcome you to the Parken National Stadium here in the beautiful city of Copenhagen, Denmark, as it is time for our featured bout of the evening, brought to you by Patina Palais and America Presents in association with Showtime Networks.
Mine damer og herrer, denne kamp, den er godkendt af Dansk Professionel Bokseforbund, V.S. Andreasen. Og lad mig med det samme præsentere dommerne. Fra West Covina, Kalifornien, Martin Denkens. Fra Helsingfors, Finland, Erkki Meronen. Og fra Belgien, Daniel Fantavile.
This bout coming away is sanctioned by the Danish Professional Boxing Association, the president, Jes Andreasen. Introducing our three judges, scoring from ringside, from West Covina, California in the United States, Marty Denken. From Helsinki, Finland, Erkki Meronen. And from Tervuren, Belgium, Daniel van der Riel.
Og kampleder i denne kamp, manden der skal dømme og styre begivenhederne, fra USA, Steve Smoker.
And our referee in charge of this bout, our third man in the ring, is Steve Smoker. All right, fans, here we go with our main event of the evening. 10 rounds of boxing scheduled in the heavyweight division. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance and boxing fans joining us around the world from Copenhagen, Denmark, it's showtime!
Rekordliste lyder på 52 sejre og kun ét nederlag. 43 af de 32 sejre, undskyld, er vundet på knockout. IBC's regerende verdensmester, Danmarks populæreste sportsmand, Super Brian Nielsen!
And ladies and gentlemen, introducing first on my right, finding out of the blue corner, wearing black trunks with white trim, hailing from Korsør, Denmark. He weighed in at 259¾ pounds. His outstanding record includes 62 wins, 1 loss, 43 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the pride of Denmark, the IBC heavyweight champion, introducing Super Brian Nielsen.
I det røde hjørne, mine damer og herrer, iført sorte shorts. Han vejer 108,6 kilo, og hans rekordliste lyder på 48 sejre, 3 nederlag og 2 kampe er dømt til no contest. 42 af de 48 sejre er vundet på knockout. Nummer 1 på WBC's verdensrangliste, mine damer og herrer, den tidligere ubesejrede verdensmester, Iron Mike Tyson!
The world over, wearing his traditional black trunks and fighting out of Catskill, New York, in the United States. He weighed in at 239 pounds with a record of 48 wins, 3 losses, 2 no contests. He has 42 big wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, he is currently ranked the WBC number 1 contender. Here is the former undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, introducing Iron Mike Tyson. And once again, Steve Smoker, our referee in charge, now to give instructions, 10 rounds of boxing schedule.
All right, gentlemen, you were given your instructions of the way. Please obey my commands at all times. Protect yourself, respect the bell. Touch gloves, God bless, thank you.
Mike Tyson looking very cut despite the extra weight. 21 of his 42 knockouts in the first round Brian Nielsen, soft in the middle, a big target. Throws wide looping punches, doesn't move his head enough. Will he try to make Tyson fight dirty? Steve Smoger, the referee. There's the bell. Round one. And Tyson goes right to work. Body shots.
Mike, there's no let up in him. He's just unloading everything. All body right now.
And as usual, with bad intentions, going to the body and the head now.
Stay up, Mike. Stay up, baby.
And Nielsen says, bring it on, Mike.
Nielsen says he believes he's strong enough to push Mike backward. I'm not sure yet.
Well, Nielsen able to withstand the first wave. Let's see what happens next. A big right hand by Tyson.
Nice overhand right. Mike doesn't normally throw a right hand that straight. That was a pretty punch.
Nielsen absorbing a lot of punishment early. Tyson missing with a wild left hook.
Right now, Nielsen's in the mode of weather the storm and get busy maybe later, because right now it's all defense.
Watch your heads, guys. Watch your heads.
Nielsen is supposed to be able to move well despite his size.
Nice jabbing right hand by Nielsen.
But so far, it's only backward.
He threw one nice
Please,
one, two
punch,
there.
Mike,
that Mike's attention
step,
a little bit. Right. Maybe trying to get his pound of flesh.
Left hook to the head by Tyson. They want Nielsen to jab. But all he does is hold now, which is probably a wise decision. Tyson continues to unload. He's got Nielsen against the ropes. A minute to go in round one. Well, Tyson just loading up with the overhand run. Again, Nielsen on the retreat. Big right hand to the head by Tyson, followed up by a left uppercut.
Mike's punching through the gloves a lot. They're not all getting through clean, but some punching is definitely being absorbed right through the gloves.
Don't punch, Mikey. Don't punch.
So far, it's been clean.
Don't punch. Step, step. Very good. Step, Mikey. Thank you.
The highly regarded Steve Smoger, who refereed the Hopkins-Trinidad fight. Well, Nielsen makes it through the first.
Mike Tyson going right to the body, working his way in on the jab, right hand to the body, trying to dig the uppercuts and hooks in on both sides, and eventually comes up top with a few uppercuts, but he stays almost exclusively to the body in that first sequence for about 30 to 40 seconds in round one.
Tommy, get out, Tommy!
In the opening round, Nielsen proving he could take a punch. He took a lot of them, overhand rights and left uppercuts. Round two, scheduled for 10. Tyson missing with a left hook.
Cut him out, Mike. Maybe punch him here, but good thanks, man.
And he continues to dig to the body, then left uppercut to the chin, Tyson. Hard body shots, then upstairs.
Those uppercuts are starting to tell, Steve. You can see the head of Nielsen snap back. They hurt.
blood coming out of the mouth of Nielsen after that last series of punches by Tyson. When Nielsen even comes close to landing, the crowd will react. But he hasn't come close to hurting Tyson. A sharp left hook there by Nielsen. Not even phasing Tyson.
Well, big guy Nielsen doesn't really have a big wallet, not big power.
Pretty good head movement there, that sequence by Tyson defensively.
One thing Nielsen does do, or he has done in the past, is throw a reasonable amount of punches for heavyweight. If he can let Mike punch himself out a little bit, cover up, and start to pepper Mike with punches, and get him clean, he has a shot of taking this fight deep and make some trouble for Mike.
Nielsen sticking the jab but doesn't follow it up. And then missing wildly.
Nielsen's already landed more punches in this round than he did against Tyson in the whole first round. So maybe that's a little bit of a preview of things to come.
Push it off, Rod. Push it off.
Final minute of the second round. Overhand right, partially blocked by Nielsen, who makes a face at Tyson. Gets a little left hand into the head of Tyson. Inside, Tyson working. Nielsen just pushing Tyson off. And then digging those right uppercuts to the midsection.
Nielsen not really throwing anything solid, even hard yet. And I don't know that Mike has a lot of respect for him. Tyson just coming forward.
Nielsen said if it can last three or four rounds, he'll be there the entire fight. Well, this is the end of the second. Combination of the head by Tyson. Nielsen still standing. And look at the left eye of Nielsen. It is cut badly.
Brian, når han kommer ind med sit hoved, så hold det nede. Tryk hans hoved nedad, for ellers giver du plads til ham.
Tag med skylderen på.
Ja. Ja. Det er godt, det du laver, men lad nu være med at blive fanget i tårerne, Brian. Hold hans hoved ned.
Okay.
Du ved, det er noget bedre.
Don't worry, it's okay.
Come here.
Give me the end of the towel. Don't worry. It's nothing at all. Don't worry.
Noget.
Brian, tie him up on the inside.
Nielsen showing that he's here to at least fight. Not here to just dance and get a beat and look a little cockiness, a little defiance. And here's where it appears that they clashed heads right there.
Mike, you're right there.
Can't tell though if that opened the cut or not.
A defiant Brian Nielsen enters into round three. The left eye was cut late in the last round on the clash of heads. Blood first appeared from the nostril of Nielsen just 40 seconds into round two.
Okay.
But it's right over the eye, I believe, there, Bobby, and it could be dripping into the eye, clouding
his
vision.
It's right between the eyebrow and the eye the lid. It's like right on the eyelid. It's pretty deep. We'll see what this corner can do.
We'll see if it becomes a factor. But Nielsen's game. Left hook to the head by Tyson. Follows it up with a straight right. Now again on the inside.
Nielsen not pushing Tyson back as he said he's going to try and do with the jab, although there he attempts a nice right hand.
Nielsen's cute, he's clever.
Don't punch. Very good.
The cover's pretty good for a big man. Gets in a little crouch, puts his arms to the sides, doesn't let too much come through too clean, but Mike is devastating with that power.
Nielsen bouncing off the ropes, getting rocked by Tyson.
Don't punch.
Tyson with an opponent here who is largely standing right in front of him, seemingly tailor-made.
Don't punch.
Let him out.
Step out, Mikey. Still an awkward fight, Steve, for any fighter when a fighter looks to just block and hold. Block and hold. It's going to be a long night of attrition for both guys.
But he is inflicting much punishment these first three rounds on the body and head of Nielsen.
Good shot.
Quick, don't punch.
Step.
Up till now, Nielsen able to weather some punishing body shots by Tyson. The crowd getting behind Nielsen.
Quick, get off his neck, Brian.
Get off his neck, Brian. Don't do that. Don't do that, Brian.
Oh, quick combination of the head. And down goes Nielsen.
He got Cole to clean up a cut, a hook and a right hand, and another hook. And he is in trouble.
Down for the second time in his career.
Hey, how we feel, Brian? You're beautiful, baby.
16 seconds to get through.
Quick, don't punch.
Nielsen looking to make it to the bell.
Low blow there, Steve.
A low blow, and Brian Nielsen doubled over. Oh, brother, as he goes down to his knees right in front of us. A low blow just at the bell to end the round.
Come on, Brian.
Will he be able to continue?
No. If it's unintentional, which it was, and he does not come out, he gets 5 minutes.
You heard Steve Smoger. The rule is if a fighter is unable to continue due to an accidental foul, he loses by TKO. But Steve Smoger indicating unintentional. So he'll get 5 minutes.
But after that 5 minutes, if he does not come out, he is a loser by TKO.
Yes.
Here we'll take a look at the nice combination by Mike Tyson on the inside. There's the hook in the right hand. The second hook in the right hand that great raises. Nielsen was already on his way down. His legs seem to be under him, and then Mike unloads a left hook right here. Oh, south of the border, and very, very solid.
You hear the crowd reacting. These are Danish rules. The one about the losing by TKO on an accidental foul. So he'll have 5 minutes to recover.
He's going to take some time. Keep your fighter ready.
All right.
It was unintentional. Please, Mikey, keep up. Please. I can't. Brian,
Steve Smoger,
he claims you're on his neck and it made the shot go low. Don't go on his neck. You're doing great. Don't go on his neck.
It's a very, very strange rule. The referee has pressure to determine whether it's intentional or unintentional. He said it was unintentional.
Yes,
he said.
Yes, he said. Han bliver træt før dig, og lad være med at blive ramt hårdt.
Så jo, det gør han.
Boks for helvede.
You want to go? Get out.
He says he's all right, and he's going to continue. He didn't even need the allotted 5 minutes.
Come on now, come on.
A gutty Brian Nielsen only needed about a minute 30. So they continue here. It is round four.
Step nice.
Tyson's longest fight since Francois Botha a couple of years ago.
Well, certainly Mike needs to get the rounds in. And Nielsen, the longer it goes, the better his chances are. But he's losing every round big.
Good shot.
Freak, don't punch.
Don't punch. Very good.
Down in the third round. And then doubled over in pain after the low blow at the end of the round.
Quick, don't punch.
That's it.
Mikey, break out of there, Mikey.
Nielsen, who has to still be reeling from the effects of that knockdown, is trying to hang tough here against Tyson.
I'm sure that knockdown got his attention, but when he stood up, he seemed to have clear eyes and his legs seemed to be under him. But that low blow seemed to take some starts right back out of him if it was indeed low.
And the rope saved him from going into the expensive seats. Big left hook on the inside of the jaw by Tyson. Oh, man, did that get the attention of Nielsen. He took a huge breath after that one. Oh, a heavy right hand after the left uppercut by Tyson.
Good. Mike's trying to work through those gloves, and he's so powerful. Sometimes, even if your hands are up, he splits them. But he's a little frustrated with the tight defense that the Big Danes are holding up.
Don't punch, I'm here.
Nielsen hoping Tyson punches himself out.
Yeah, but right now he's doing it on Nielsen.
Unfortunately for the Danes. These punches by Nielsen being telegraphed. And Tyson continues to have his way every round.
I'm here, Brian. Come on. Hands up, guys. Hands up.
If you don't have some power and give something Mike to respect, you will definitely not get any from Mike. You need to get your pound of flesh. Right now, Nielsen can't.
Put your head up. Keep your head up, okay? That's all right. He's all right. Come on.
Steve Smoker warning Tyson to keep his head up. That straight right by Nielsen was blocked by Tyson. Keep the head up so he doesn't clash heads with Nielsen. Which already has been a problem.
Nice jab for Mike. He's gotten away from the jab. Worried all just about power now.
Digging body shot with the right hand. Oh, a series of right uppercuts by Tyson. And those to the head of Brian Nielsen. Almost everything is connecting by Tyson. Final seconds, and that's it for the four. Well, he's made it this far.
Prøv at høre, Ben. Lejerne bliver oppe. En ting til. Nu kan du godt begynde at bokse og slå. Okay? Du kan ramme ham med det, du skal. Højre hånd til kroppen, venstre hånd til hook. De er lige stået ind. Du kan ramme ham nu. Og det gør du også. Den korte højre hånd, når han kommer vælte frem.
Let's revisit the knockdown in round three. Mike Tyson working on the inside. Gets through with that right hand, but then he starts to work the left hand around and right again, and that left hook sends Nielsen crashing to the floor. Right before the very end of that round, a low blow landed by Mike Tyson. We'll see if we can get a better look at it.
Let's go.
That one is on the belt line. That one hit white. That hit the white belt line. Technically not a low blow, but ruled one.
Round five, so much for Tommy Brooks's prediction. Tyson's trainer of a fourth round knockout for his man.
Reiterate
that Brian Nielsen indicated if he can get past the fourth round without getting knocked out, which he has done, he'll be there the whole fight. We shall see. Tyson all over Nielsen.
All right, Brian.
Vicious shots upstairs. Left-right combination up to the head by Tyson. Some of that got through.
Nice Mike Tyson punching and fighting when he wants to, wrestling when he wants to. Nielsen not giving him anything to worry about, pretty much.
And again, those long punches by Nielsen being telegraphed, allowing Tyson plenty of time to duck away. Right there, and then he countered with a left uppercut to the chin to Tyson.
And most of Nielsen's punches are all arm punches, too, Steve. They're not big power shots.
The crowd trying to get behind and inspire the game, but he's going to need more than crowd support. Big right, heavy right hand to the head by Tyson. He is just teeing off.
Don't punch.
Punishing Nielsen here. Through four plus rounds.
Don't punch.
Nielsen trying to come forward and just smother Mike's punches and hold on to him. Use his weight to walk him backward just to stay out of harm's way.
And a jab by Tyson. And now Nielsen tying him up. Danielson has not been, as strong as he is, has not been able to push Tyson back. He just nailed Tyson with a right hand. Tyson walked into it.
But it wasn't a well-delivered right hand. It was a big slap, swing, wide. Not something Mike has to worry about just yet.
Crowd hoping for a miracle here. The cut opens up over the left eye of Nielsen, who's getting hammered.
Big uppercut by Mike. Double left uppercut in the right hand.
Step out, Mike. Step out, babe. Step out. Nope.
The cut of the left eyelid. That's only one of many worries for Nielsen right now.
Step way back of the ring.
Nobody thought it would go this far.
Woo! Woo! I know. If you look at a jab just like you're using it. Okay, now, like I told you the last round, you're looking at a jab, then drop that right hand in there.
Six coming.
Thank you. It's round six coming up, baby. Use your jab now, Mike. The man is on his heels. You can't see. Double, triple up with the jab, then looking at the jab, then you drop that right hand in there. And then dig that body shot, just like we worked on back in the locker room. Okay? How you feel?
I feel good.
Great, fantastic.
You look good moving.
Fantastic.
You're having some.
Them short combinations coming too, they're working for you.
You make a miss, come up, punch. You're doing good. Keep it up.
We're going to see Tyson on the way. Now, Nielsen's going to throw out a little jab here, but the right hand is not that clean. He throws it, it loops it around, just catches Mike right on the chin there, but it's a real slap. Watch. He tips a little jab out there. And it's just a slap. It's not a good clean right hand. The crowd made it seem like it was more than it was. One more look.
Get out of here.
Again,
get out
just
of
a
here.
Smack and not even clean. Just
punch,
grazing
punch,
at best.
Step nice.
Round
step
six,
back.
The longest Tyson fight since Holyfield won in 1996. And he lost that. The last time he won a fight past the fifth round was versus Razor Ruddock, Ruddock 2, 10 years ago.
Wondering
has gone 10 rounds or more in 5 years.
I'm sorry, Nielsen is so big at 259, but he's not a puncher. He's big, very strong physically, not big. One of his assets was that he threw a lot of punches to outwork his opponents, not coming close with Mike.
Step.
Nielsen basically in a survival mode right now.
I completely agree, Steve. Tyson's unloading on him on that will. He's just looking to stay the distance. It's a moral badge of courage. Moral victory of sorts.
If he goes the distance, forget about winning. If he just goes the distance because he's losing every round, they may anoint him King of Denmark.
I wouldn't be shocked.
We're not sure what that says about Tyson, although Tyson not looking bad.
I was just going to say, Steve, some people can get into a defensive mode. James Bone Crusher Smith years ago, he just made sure he didn't get hurt. Fought Mike, never really tried to win, but never didn't want to get hurt. Never left himself open to get hurt. Nielsen doing something similar. Not really fighting Mike that much, but not getting hurt that much.
Freak, don't punch, don't punch. Come here.
With the exception of that low blow, which was borderline, and the unintentional clash of heads, it's been a fairly clean situation. Nobody's trying to really induce anybody into a dirty situation.
No, Nielsen's doing a lot of holding. Mike's just trying to beat on anything that he can. You know, he's taking his time quite a bit because he has no sense of urgency. Nielsen's not coming back with a lot of counterpunches. Mike can do what he wants, and I think it's really hard to look good with this type of opponent with Mike's style anyway.
The one knockdown, the 2:30 mark of round three. Nielsen went down the ropes, saving him from going into the seats off a barrage of punches.
Hey, don't punch, don't punch. Very good, very good.
Nielsen just hanging around. Oh, a big right hand by Tyson to the head.
Left uppercut started that too, Steve. He got his head up in the air and almost took it off.
Another slashing right, a right cross. Nielsen with a little head fake there. He tries to come back. A right hand to the head by Nielsen. Gets the crowd going. Tyson backing Nielsen into the corner, and then Nielsen holding on.
To his credit, Nielsen's got a little bit of attitude.
Oh, yes, a lot. Right hand by Tyson to the left ear. but not much power behind that.
Brother, I'm like, very good, very good.
Nielsen's
very
made
good.
It through six.
Fantastic, man.
Good work. Good work. Keep working.
You're working fantastic, Mike. I like to see you double, triple up with the jab. I like to double, see you double, triple up with the jab.
Combination. Combination.
Word spread, brother.
Hold your head up. Relax.
Take a deep breath.
Relax.
Take a deep breath. How you feel?
Good.
Keep working. Good. Working good. Double, triple up, man. This guy's just trying to hang on, man. He knows.
Famous for his left hook. It appears that Mike lands a little bit overhand right there on the jawline after an uppercut. Got Nielsen's head up in the air a little bit. Take another look at it from the other side. There's the uppercut and the right hand. That right hand does land on the temple and jawline pretty cleanly.
Tyson may be wondering what is holding this guy up. Well, at this point, will Tyson's new conditioning coach make a difference, or will it matter? Because Steve Smoker.
There's no rule to cover you. I have to declare him the winner. Do you want me to do that?
Yeah.
Tell me in your own way.
Yeah.
I love you, babe. I'm going to declare him the winner right now. All right, corner?
Okay.
Mike Tyson, you win.
That's
retired.
It.
Mike.
It's over.
It's gone. Wonderful.
He could take, I think, Steve.
Brian Nielsen in his corner, staying on his stool. He had every opportunity to continue. Steve Smoker said, I want to hear your words. And he chose not to continue.
And immediately some hugging and friendship ensues.
A punishing attack every round. That just wore Nielsen down and out eventually. Tyson dominating every round, knocked him down in the third, cut him up.
It appeared right when Steve Smoker came over and told him he's the winner. Nielsen came over, congratulated him, and Mike complimented him back. I couldn't hear what he said, but it had something to do with, in a little more of a colorful fashion, good fight. Darn good fight, and he was happy about the outcome.
Well, I think he earned, Tyson's respect here. The guy got through six. A lot of folks thought this was going to end within just a couple of rounds.
I got it. Let me do it.
Get the official announcement momentarily. Mike Tyson goes to 49-3, two no contests.
But I kept saying to Tommy, is he tired? He said, no, he said, just keep
there with his
off.
Advisor, Shelly Finkel.
So beautiful.
Yeah, he's a real pro.
He's like a real pro.
You did your thing.
All right, now. That motherfucker.
No.
That motherfucker took some shit.
Jay Bright whispering into his ear.
We're keeping the building tomorrow.
Yeah, we're keeping him.
From the custom auto days.
Right, the guy couldn't take anymore. You want
Mike?
Yeah.
First time he went down on his leg.
Yeah.
You put him down. First time he went down, Mike.
Yeah. Question now, what's next for Mike Tyson? Anybody's guess.
Come on in.
No one ever truly knows what to expect with Tyson.
Oh, I know so.
Let's just hope it's not another year or so before he fights again.
You look great, boy.
Mike! So Brian Nielsen says no moss in essence after the sixth round, and can you blame him? He was just getting destroyed just about every round. Absorbing a lot of punishment.
Not the type of fighter that even has a one-punch knockout chance against a guy like Mike Tyson.
Tim, look at this. He's not even breathing.
But a moral victory of sorts for the Dane as he lasted this long with Mike Tyson. Very game competitor, Brian Nielsen. We'll get the official word from Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Mine damer og herrer, efter et sekunds boksning, i syvende omgang, vinder på teknisk knockout, Iron Mike Tyson!
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time of 1 second in round number 7. Brian Nielsen explains to the referee that he could not see out of his left eye. Unable to continue, our referee in charge, Steve Smoker, stops the contest. The winner by way of technical knockout, Iron Mike Tyson.
Well, the official word is that Nielsen couldn't continue because he couldn't see out of his left eye. Nielsen joins the list of fighters lasting into and getting knocked out of the seventh round against Tyson. That includes Tyrell Biggs and Donovan Razor Ruddock. Let's go to Jim Gray.
Very much, Steve. Mike, congratulations. You have not fought in 1 year. How would you assess your performance? You're not even breathing hard.
I've been training in the gym for a long period of time, putting a lot of rounds of boxing, and I'm just all praise be to God that he made me healthy enough to perform well. And I like to say I love all my children, my family, Sean, Monica, Maida, everyone. I'm back, and I just look forward to fight again. He was a tough guy. It was hard to hit him, but it was good I got those 7 rounds. Yeah.
You've needed the rounds. You've only had 14 rounds in the past 5 years. Mike, I want to ask you, the assessment might be that people think you should have knocked Brian Nielsen out. However, would you say that this is your best fight in 5 years?
Well, you give me your opinion. What do you think?
I would think it is. What do you think?
Well, I put up a good fight. He was tough. He was game. I look forward to do better in my next fight, and all praise be to God.
Mike, at what point now, you said you wanted to take it slow before you went after the championship. It's been a real slow process. Are you ready now to attempt to fight either Rockman, Lewis winner?
Well, when I fight those guys, I probably have to train a little harder and probably 2 more fights and I'll be ready for the championship of the world.
Right. 2 more fights, but will it be a quicker timetable? Because you're almost running out of time, aren't you, with the clock?
Oh, no, I feel great. I'm doing great. I'm working great, and I'm getting better at time.
40 pounds, 240 is what you weighed in. 238, 239, whatever it was. Maybe the scale was a little bit off, but it's 17 pounds heavier than your last fight. Was that your intention?
Well, he's a big guy, and I wanted to put on more weight to put more leverage in my punching, and it was successful in doing so. I was laying hard shots, and he was taking them, and I was saying, God, when he came to the ring, I said, man, you shouldn't have quit. You should have kept fighting, man. You're putting on a hell of a fight.
Mike, when you say 2 more fights, who exactly would you like to face before those guys?
Well, I don't know anyone. I'm just looking for my Shelly Finkel. I'll make the arrangements, and I'm just looking forward to it.
Will you step up the competition? Will it be somebody, Tua, a Holyfield, somebody who people have heard of and can recognize?
Probably one more fight, and then after that fight, yes.
Mike, congratulations.
Thank you very much, Jim Gray.
Good to see you. Thank you, Mike. Let's bring in the Brian Nielsen. Brian, you are an awful game fighter tonight. Are you proud of your performance?
What? One time, man. I don't hear what to say.
Are you proud of your performance? You were an awful game fighter this evening.
No, I'm not proud because I want to go this distance.
Anthony, excuse us. Folks, Mike Tyson's group is trying to leave the ring. That's the confusion here. We'll get through it. Brian, I now know what you just went through for those past 7 rounds to a small degree. You wanted the fight to be stopped. The referee came over and asked you, and you said you'd had enough?
No, I don't say that.
I stopped the fight.
You stopped the fight?
Yes.
You were ready to continue?
Yeah, I mean, every time he hit me hard on the left eye, I got nothing to see. And that's, that's bullshit, because if he knocked me out, he wanted to never knock me out. I can take everything. I believe that, and I have never been down, and he wanted to never get me down.
Well, you went down. You went down in that third round.
Yeah.
What happened there?
I'm out of balance, and he hit me because he hit hard, and not hard enough to knock me out.
A lot of people will say, I mean, you took a tremendous, tremendous beating, and you managed to maintain. And in fact, even in the sixth round, when you were getting hit, you had somewhat of an attitude, is what Bobby Chess said. Were you a little defiant?
What?
Yes. Definitely.
He's defiant. English is not your first language, and I apologize.
Okay.
What will you do next?
I will get a chance more. That's bullshit. I don't get him. I mean, I have my title, so I want to defend that. And I hope Tyson want to fight me again, and this time I beat him.
Tyson fight again. You want that again?
Yeah, of course I want that.
What makes you think you could beat the guy after what you just went through? What makes you think you could ever win a fight like that?
I caught. And I have never get a call when nothing can see. And
you couldn't see anything.
That's do that from my eyes every time he hit me.
Brian, you fought a good fight.
I hope that.
And we've enjoyed our time here in Denmark. Congratulations to you.
And he said, after that's everything for me.
He said, is that what Mike told you? You took everything from me?
I'm a good fighter and a hard hitter.
Indeed you are. Thank you. Thank you, Brian.
Thank you.
Let's bring in the referee here.
Brian.
Steve.
Magnificent. Magnificent heart. God bless you. Hi, Jim.
Steve, how are you?
Fantastic.
It's been a busy few weeks for you.
Thank God. Thank God.
Steve. You went over and you told Brian, I love you,
yeah,
but I'm going to listen to your corner.
Right.
What did he say?
He told me that he could not see. He said he was seeing in his Danish. He could not see. It was wiggling. I noticed that the eye was cut. It was swelling, and there was like a blood formation.
You gave him a choice, and his choice was what? Was it his choice or the corner?
It was his choice. I did not. I have a high respect for the corner.
Yep.
I told him, all due respect, I want it from his mouth. When he told me... I said, Brian, you realize that in your country, that if you cannot continue, even though I had declared that an accidental butt, they do not go to cards, you lose. Do you understand the term, you lose? He said, yes, I do. I said, I'm now going to go over and declare Mike Tyson the winner by TKO. He said, okay.
Steve, there was an accidental headbutt and an accidental, I don't know how you determine that, low blow. A low blow is a low blow. I mean,
is a low blow, Jim. But Brian, if you'll note, was pushing his head down, thereby causing the shot. It was an unintentional low blow. Let me say this. Mike Tyson is a true gentleman. We had a nice discussion in the dressing room. He assured me that he would keep it clean, and I didn't want his reputation to precede him. He obeyed every command, every break. In this corner, at the bell, he had loaded up. And when I came there and I said stop, he stopped it. So I want to just give credit where credit is due.
Steve, thank you.
He was magnificent. Thank you, sir.
Nice job tonight.
Thank you, sir.
All right, Steve, that's the story from up here in the ring. Down to you.
Thank you, Jim. A very clear and succinct explanation by the third man of the ring, referee Steve Smoger. He really did a terrific job tonight as we wrap things up from ringside. Let's go back now and listen to Steve Smoger in the corner with Brian Nielsen.
What do you say?
He can't see.
He's left eye.
Now listen to me. Time out. Time out. Brian.
Yeah.
If you can't see, Brian, there's no rule to cover you.
Yeah.
I have to declare him the winner. Do you want me to do that?
Yeah.
Tell me in your own way.
Yeah.
I love you, babe. I'm going to declare him the winner right now. All right, corner?
Yeah.
Okay. Mike Tyson, you win. Retired. Mike.
So Steve Smoger giving Brian Nielsen every opportunity to continue, but the vision was impaired in the left eye, and he stopped it in the seventh.
Steve Smoger made it extremely clear, very definitive, couldn't have been more fair and done the right thing any better than he did. Perfect job, consummate referee.
All right, we'll be back to sum things up in a moment, but looking ahead, let's see what boxing coverage is coming up in the near future here on Showtime.